I want to congratulate Pastor Dewey Friedel, a great man of God, and a beautiful heart, a man with a lot of love. And to have so much love like Pastor Dewey have, you have to suffer a lot. And out of the suffering, the anointing will come out. This anointing pastor getting to every nation through Praise the Lord and being a great friend, a great spiritual man, anointed. To be anointed, you have to pass by the fire. You have to pass by the oven. To be anointed, you have to give up your flesh. And this pastor, this friend of mine, great friend, had done that. You got to die to the flesh so you can live in the spirit. And he died to the flesh and live on the spirit. Humble, with a very humanity heart, a wonderful message, and a great, great friend. Congratulations, Pastor Dewey, in your beautiful day.
I dreamed I went to heaven, and you were there with me. We walked upon the streets of gold, beside the crystal sea. We heard the angels singing, and someone called your name.
Hello, Pastor Dewey, my good friend. This is Matthew Barnett. I just want to say congratulations on one more year of pastoring, one more year of moving forward at all costs for the cause of Christ. We just appreciate you so much, and you've been such a dear friend, and all these years you've been coming to the Dream Center and blessing us with your crazy messages and your props of Goliath in your head, in your hand, and all that you've done here, buddy. We love you and appreciate you so much, Dewey, and thank God for you. Thank God for friends, and thank God for everyone that's stood behind you and supported you as you're pastoring one more year of a great ministry. God bless you. We love you.
We turned and saw this young man, and he was smiling as he came. And he said, "Friend, you may not know me now." And then he said, "But wait. You used to teach my Sunday school when I was only 8. And every week you would say a prayer before the class would start. And one day when you said that prayer, I asked Jesus in my heart."
Pastor Dewey, I am so excited to make this video for you today. On this Pastor's Appreciation Sunday, I hope you genuinely understand how much we all love and appreciate you. You have meant so much to me personally, and my life in Los Angeles, and now my future life in San Diego, to my family. You have blessed us, you've loved us, and I'm now moving into a new season, a new adventure, because of your belief in me and your support. And I pray that on this Pastor's Appreciation Sunday, that you will know how valuable you are to the kingdom of God, how much we love you, and how incredible your life and your legacy and your ministry is. Church, I challenge you to love your pastor, take care of your pastor, protect him, encourage him, because you've been blessed with one of the greatest pastors in America today. Pastor Dewey, from my family, we love you and appreciate you. Have a great Sunday.
I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave.
I believe we got to open our minds and hearts to do the great things that never been done before. I believe God has saved the best things for last. I believe God always has an ace up his sleeve. No matter how much you've been beaten down, there is a nevertheless in your life where God is saying, if you'll move into this third anointing right now, if you'll take what I have for you, you'll be able to face the thing that has been your undoing. You'll be able to face the thing that has defied you and defied your God. And you're going to have victory over that as you step out in faith. And this time, you won't have to do it alone because you have some friends with you. You have some friends who believe in you this time. You have a pastor who believes in you. You have a pastor's blessing over your life that is most precious. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the breakthrough anointing. And the breakthrough anointing is the poured out anointing. It's the anointing that sets the captive free. It's the anointing that puts the devil on the run. It's the anointing that will put you on the map and the place of God's purpose in your life.